January the 10th of my practice diary progression journey. I have one of those faces that will always reflect what I'm feeling. And any of those who have been following my diary since October will probably know me quite well, actually, even through these. So today started as it generally does. I have a certain routine, and I find routines, particularly as I'm working on my own and progressing in the job side, but also running the business and practice and the house and all of that. So I'm one that that likes routines, not rigidity of routines, but routines that give my day a structure. In the middle of the day, I got a phone call from my cousin to say the appalling news that who would be probably my half-cousin, but I don't think in halves and full, died very, very suddenly. He was a young man in his 40s with a young family, and any young death is tragic, even though I have a strong spiritual basis and knowledge, of course, with my Jewish beliefs. But the shock is horrible for the family and for all of us as we try and understand how and why these things happen. But I'm not going to get into that because that's deeply personal and that follows my own beliefs, which I feel are private. To watch suffering is really, I didn't know him terribly well. We're quite a sort of disparate family, I would say, in many respects. But it doesn't, when you hear about a young life and the devastation, it is incredibly shocking. And how can we be prepared? And this is what I suppose I'm taking into this diary. We always try and be prepared, and preparation, whether it's practice preparation, whether it's preparing for dinner party, whether it's preparing for a journey, whether it's preparing for an operation, whether it's preparing to go on holiday, whatever that preparation is, it must include the preparation of our transient journey through this life. I read a lot on the philosophies and Chabad because that's part of life and part of giving some understanding, and I would say in a case like this, some preparation, as much as one could ever be prepared for such news. So do we stop the day? Do I stop the day? Yes, I did briefly stop the day after our long conversation with my cousin to say some quiet prayers, and then the day must continue. But of course, the shadow of that news will be with me, because even from a distance, I want to feel useful, and that's what we want to do when we see other people in trouble or suffering sadness. So, but the day must continue, and I am finishing off work and getting on with some practice. Yesterday was really, I can feel that that the solo E-flat clarinet pieces are progressing, and my rhythm sense is coming back. And it's so interesting because we keep our, you know, with the warm-up and fingers and all of that side and the mouth and everything that we use in playing. But sight reading and rhythm and that side of things needs to be kept up as well. It's a different sort of cognition, and certainly one that I can lose very very easily and suddenly be kind of slightly stammered, confused by rhythms. But as slowly over these last 3-4 days of of working on these two pieces and the complexities of Rob Keeley's piece. It is, I'm happy to say, starting to flow, which is really great. Interesting yesterday, because it was the first time for a little bit that I went back to Orfeo, the Theo Musgrave E-flat clarinet piece. And I think when we return to a piece that I've worked at incredibly over a very long period of time, and also put down the kind of what will be the basis for the electronic side, which we recorded at the same time, just to give a kind of structure to how the timings would be. It'll all be made much more clear when it's released. So I went back with a certain assumption, as I think we often do, of a piece that we have known very, very well, and assume that certain things will stick. And this is a piece, actually, Thea and Rob are not unlike each other in that the notes are not always what one assumes. You've really got to read. Well, we can't read every note because, and I won't get started on the chunking side and how the brain processes chunks of information. But there is a certain assumption that certain things and certain patterns will stick. And going back yesterday, I realised it's not going to be like quite like going back to the beginning, but it will be going back to some rigorous learning. What I find also really curious is that I go to, particularly on the E-flat, certain fingerings, because we have to use some different fingerings to make sure the brightness of the top notes from E-flat upwards are correct. And in the first instance, I'd go to what I had my sort of go-to, and then I noticed on the page I'd written the fingering because I'd obviously had to override that go-to. So it's interesting how we lay down certain things which, when we come back to them, they're still there. And that's why the careful learning at the very beginning is crucial, because that's the bit that we really that can really stick very strongly. Anyway, with a Zoom shortly and some calls later, I want to at least do, I'm going to do a shortened warm-up, and I want to go back to the E-flat pieces and have the E-flat warm, and then I will, after the calls and the meetings, come back to the E-flat pieces, because I really, there's a momentum now, and momentum is incredibly, incredibly important. Anyway, the day continues, and we never know what the day may bring, and that's why I think that our ability to be self-aware and to always be looking to resources where we can get greater understanding of how we manage ourselves and emotional intelligence and practical and all the rest of it. We have so much to learn in life and so much to manage, and so often in so many circumstances I certainly feel very ill-equipped to deal with them, but I always strive to read and know more to be perhaps a little more prepared, as much as we can ever be in this rather unexpected life and the future life holds for us. Anyway,